The most clear place where we understand this idea of the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ making its way into us by faith and God calling us to function in our walk with him by faith in the gospel is Philippians chapter 2, verses 12, the latter part of that verse, and verse 13. It gives sort of a compatibility of our responsibility that God places on us for pursuing holiness, but then the responsibility of God to be the overarching superintendent of our walk with him to grow spiritually. And so on the one hand, it says, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Working out your salvation there points to us utilizing the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ by faith as a way to begin to vigorously fight, begin to vigorously work and vigorously mortify the flesh and vigorously work out our soul salvation with fear and trembling by grabbing a hold of all of God's means of grace that he utilizes to grow us. In other words, you're not gonna grow unless you pursue the spheres and the means by which God grows us spiritually. So in verse 13 of Philippians 2 though, it shows that the whole thing is God's responsibility. For it is God who works and wills and works for us his good pleasure. Because he's the one that works in us to give us the commitment and strength to be able to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. So the death of Christ, Christ's death on the cross by paying our fee, by God's wrath being poured out on him, him being buried and him being raised from the dead, that justifies us, that brings us into a relationship with God, but it also helps us to maximize our relationship with God. So it's not initiated by us. Our spiritual growth is initiated by God. So he works in us by pushing us by the power of the Spirit to grab a hold of prayer, to grab a hold of the Word of God, to get in the community of the saints, to get under the Word of God. And so in light of that reality, what happens now is he wills in us. He works out his will in us by us pursuing holiness and to work according to his good pleasure. So God brings himself pleasure. This is crazy to me. God brings himself pleasure. He gets the ultimate pleasure in our lives out of him working and willing his desire for us to look more like Jesus Christ, to be chiseled into the image of Christ, to look more like him. And so in every single area of our life now, we're now empowered. So what's beautiful is that God gives us responsibility, but the whole of the responsibility is not on us to make ourselves holy. God pushes us and gives us affections for growth, affections for looking like Jesus. And sometimes when you're in those places where you're sort of in a place where you feel stagnant and you know that there's growth taking place, that's not you just noticing that. That's God by his Spirit doing the gracious work of putting the alarms on in you and signaling you that something's wrong. And these alarms that go off in your soul as a believer is a grace from him to call you to a commitment to the beauty of what it means to grow in holiness, to walk with him and be strengthened through the gospel.